TSQT is a statistical function that implements the probability density function of a chi-squared distribution. You need to provide to TSQT the value for which you want to run the function and the degrees of freedom that changes the shape of the distribution function. Finally, you provide the third argument, cumulative, that defines whether you want the function for that point or the cumulative value. It is useful to look at how the degrees of freedom change the shape of the statistical function. This is the distribution with a degree of freedom of 4, and you see that if I change it to 5 or to 7, the shape of the distribution function changes. It is also useful to look at the different values of degree of freedom in the same chart to see how the degrees of freedom change the shape of the statistical function. In this example, what I did is I created a variable containing values from 0 to 10 with 0.28 of step. I use a fixed value for the degree of freedom, 5, and then cumulative true and false are useful only for readability of the further code. For each value, I return the chi-squared distribution for the value with the given degree of freedom and the distribution function with cumulative true. You see that for 0.28, the chi-square is 0.017 and the cumulative is 0.002. You can also use the inverse function. The inverse function requires the argument to be a cumulative value and returns the original value. You also have the right-tail version of the chi-square, which is linked to the chi-square by this formula. The chi-square distribution right tail is 1 minus the chi-square distribution.